Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you TCP segment header and I'll explain you how port addresses are there with TCP segment header. In my last video, I have explained you how we have transport layer. Transport layer output is segment and input to transport layer, that is data, right? This data may be anything like video data, it may be audio data, it may be image data, it may be web page data, it may be text data. This data could be anything. That data may be having large size, right? But large size data that we don't forward on computer network. What we forward is, we forward segments. So you see large size data that we bisect into segments. And this segment, that is what I'm going to explain you in terms of TCP segment. So first of all, you should know, see this session layer that gives output as data and that we convert into segment at transport layer, and TCP is functioning at transport layer, right? So here with segment, how many things that we need to understand? See, in segment, first of all, you need to understand how processes are there. Why? The reason is, if you talk about transmitter and receiver, then in transmitter and receiver, there can be multiple processes. Let me give you one example. For example, in your computer, you want to access computer network. Then you may be using so many processes. Like in mobile, you may be using WhatsApp. In mobile, you may be using YouTube application. In mobile, you may be using web browser, right? Similarly, in computer also, there can be so many processes. In computer, you may be using web browser like Google Chrome, Firefox, Mozilla. In computer, you may be using Skype. In computer, you may be using Microsoft Outlook. So all those applications are executing processes in your computer. So with all the processes, first of all, there will be well-defined port number. There will be well-defined port number. And along with data, we provide sequence number, right? So first you need to understand how port number is there. So first of all, you need to understand how processes are there. Processes are there with respect to which application that you execute in your mobile or computer, right? So with given process, there will be well-defined port number. So if you observe TCP segment header, in that first part, that is source port and destination port. So source port and destination port, that is there for transmitter and receiver, right? And if you observe size of source port and destination port, then that is having size of 16 bits. So as per 16 bits, how many processes are possible, or you can say how many port numbers are possible? So based on 16 bits, you can say 2 to the power 16 number of port numbers are available, right? So if you further see the basic details of source and destination port, then that is having size of 16 bits, as I have told you over here. So port can range in between 0 to 2 to the power 16 minus 1. So 0 to 65535, that many port numbers are available. So with each process, there will be one port number to access computer network, right? See here, further you need to understand how this range is there. The reason is, in competitive examination as well as in university examination, I have seen some questions are frequently coming based on port number. So you should know, see, 0 to 1023 means in total 1024. These many port numbers, those are pre-assigned as per IANA. So IANA have assigned this port number, those are pre-assigned, right? Like with HTTP, port number 80 is used. With SMTP, port number 25 is used. See, SMTP is simple mail transfer protocol. So with mail, 25 is the port number that is assigned. With FTP, file transfer protocol, 21 port is assigned. With Telnet, 23 is assigned. With SSH, 22 port is assigned. Likewise, there are some well-defined processes with which pre-assigned port numbers are there. So whenever you use HTTP in your computer, you should know you will be using port number that is 80, right? In case of email, you will be using port number that is 25. If you transfer file, in that case, you will be using port number 21. So you should be having those many basics idea about how port numbers are there with some well-defined process, right? If you observe here, another range is like 1024 to 49151. So this port number range, those are reserved for future. Those are reserved for future, but practically, as if you implement any application and if you want to test it, in that case, you can use this port, right? But those are reserved for future. It is not assigned by IANA. And if you observe this range, 49152 to 65535, those are private ports, right? So for private communication, we can use these ports. So first of all, you should be having idea about what is port number, right? So here in TCP segment, we have source port and destination port that is having size of 16 bits. So obviously range is there from 0 to 2 to the power 16 minus 1, that is 65535. Out of this range, 0 to 1023, that is pre-assigned as per IANA, and some examples that I have given over here. The reason is, in majority of cases, we are using these processes, right? See, 1024 to 49151, that is reserved for future, and 149152 to 65535, those are private ports, right? So that is how port number is there. And one more essential key thing that I would like to explain here, the reason is that comes frequently in computer explanation. Like when you execute anything on computer network, you might have heard this term, that is network socket. So what is that network socket? See, it is a combination of IP and port. Usually you will be observing people used to write this as TCP IP. So TCP is functioning along with IP, internet protocol, right? TCP is functioning along with IP, and that functioning, that is been explained as per addresses. So obviously I have explained you how port is there, as likewise we have already seen how IP is there. IP is internet protocol. So IP also explains you address. IP is used for logical addressing. So we have discussed internet protocol in great detail, how IPv4 and IPv6 is there, right? So see, this IP plus port, that gives you network socket. So network socket, that explains you with which exact process communication should happen. Like you see, here we are having transmitter, here we are having receiver. In transmitter, let us say we are having process 1. I don't know what is that process, but process 1 is there, right? In the receiver, let us say we are having process 2. But this communication, logical addressing on computer network, that happens via IP. So here with transmitter, let us say IP1 is there. With receiver, let us say IP2 is there. So this is what IP, which explains you how logical addressing will happen in computer network. But practically, when you want to execute any process at that time, you should know what is port number. As I have told you, like with HTTP, port number 80 will be there. With SMTP, port number 25 will be there, right? So likewise, port number will be there in transmitter and receiver. So along with port number, if you combine IP, then that explains you what will be the exact address of process, right? So network socket, that explains you exact address of process along with logical addressing. So it is a combination of IP plus port. For example, if I say here we are having one IPv4 IP, right, that is written over here. Along with that, if I write port, then you see, along with logical addressing, port number, that is written. So whenever you listen this term network socket, then you should know IP plus port combination, that is network socket, right? Now in next video, I'll explain you how sequence number and acknowledgement number is there in TCP segment header. And I have seen so many questions are coming from TCP IP in competitive examination as well as in university examination. So I'll explain you each and every term along with practical example. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.